What?
Kathy, I think that my... Oh, stuff it.
Everything's a rush. Everything's a trial. Everything's difficult. And so we'd see the script day or two before we'd start to shoot it. So my inner life was something that I nuanced myself. You couldn't possibly know if you were going to be on the ship or on some alien, you know, planet. Or it was absolutely impossible to determine these factors. So all I could be responsible for was the creation and the life force of Janeway herself.
Humans aren't supposed to be in this quadrant for another 100 years.
I didn't bring them here. Nothing to do with me.
How did you get out, Q?
I'm afraid we're responsible for that.
Oh, well, I guess that's what we get for having a woman in the captain's seat. You know, I was betting that Riker would get this command.
May I assume you're the Q I've heard so much about?
Have you heard about little me? Oh, do tell. Has Jean-Luc been whispering about me behind my back? Say, is this a ship of the Valkyries? Or have you human women finally done away with your men altogether?
It had been a boys' club for a long time. And let me say, here and now, a very successful one. So I think that the game, the rules of the game were clear. You got the job. It's timely. We've broken all records here and all philosophical conjecture by putting a female into the seat. So you do what we tell you to do and it'll be fine. Of course, they're brighter than that and they're better than that. And they realized in fairly short order that the marriage, only the marriage between the actress and the character is going to make the character a soaring success. However, they were reluctant to let go of the reins in that regard. And I would say it took about 2 seasons for Rick to say, look it, she's obviously got her own handle on this character. Let's let her fly and see what happens.
This is going to make for an amusing diversion. Will you send him to prison for eternity? Or will you assist in his suicide plan? That's a toughie, but then again, that's why they made you captain, isn't it? To handle the real tough ones. My, my. Now I guess we get to find out whether the pants really fit.
I remember from that moment forward talking to them creatively about the writing and being respected. I remember, I think it was probably an episode called Death Wish, wanting very much to be an integral part of that process. And I remember Berman saying very clearly, you just go for it. We'll back off from now on.
Let me begin by stating clearly that I expect all parties to act appropriately and with respect for these proceedings. I will not have this hearing turned into a circus. Is that clear? Is that clear, Q?
Madam Captain, we are dealing here with an issue of the greatest importance to the Q continuum. I can assure you we take this matter very seriously.
Thank you. And please don't call me Madam Captain.
Talk about serendipity. It was remarkable. As all wonderful things in life are done, aren't they? Matthew Lombardo, the playwright, wrote this with me specifically in mind. He was lying in bed with my best friend. This is not as naughty as it sounds. And they were watching Star Trek Voyager. And he said, she should play Hepburn. Can you get a play to her? And Nancy said, yes, I will. Ran down to Miami, did it in 3 days, and sent it to me at Paramount. I was still shooting Voyager. And I recognized it immediately as the excellent piece of work that it was. Fun is a word I would be careful about applying to this particular venture. It's been total, which is better than fun. Also harder than fun. It speaks to the Yankee spirit that they want to be reminded of who it is who is truly iconic in this nation, who has defined it and why. And Kate Hepburn certainly did it. So they are there to be reminded about what is great about being a Yankee. But isn't it an amazing thing to be able to draw this parallel in one's life? I've been able to play the captain of a starship, this extraordinary movie actress. I mean, two iconic characters. They would talk about their leadership qualities. There would be a lot of talk about love and sex, since that's what would be sacrificed, I'm sure. Probably a discussion of loneliness.
You are one of my most valued officers. And you are my friend. It is vital that you understand me here. I need you. But I also need to know that I can count on you.
When it was over, I was devastated and couldn't understand why I was devastated. Just over. And it was over. I mean, they shot the last thing and that chair came out from under me and those lights went off so fast. Picardo showed up in the doorway. I saw a silhouette of a man, and there was Bob Picardo holding his arms out to me. So tough, tough to say goodbye to it. It meant seven of the most complicated, marvelous, revolutionary, wonderful, privileged years of my life. People often say to me, oh, well, now you're typecast, you know, it's done. You're Kathryn Janeway. And I say, really, if that were the reality, I wouldn't be so shameful, would it? She was a great character. I was very, very honored, very blessed to play her. And I'd do it again. I loved that chapter. I loved it.